telling why I got cut off. We're gonna finish it up, part two, right? I was in the book of Job, right? So let's read that again. It's the book of Job, right? Chapter 33, right? Pick up right where we left off, right? Through the Spirit. This is Job 33 and 23. If there be a messenger with him, an interpreter, one among a thousand, to show unto man his uprightness, then he is gracious unto him, and saith, deliver him, so like from going down to the pit, I have found a ransom. His flesh shall be fresher than a child's. He shall return to his days of his youth. Right? Meaning what? He's born again. Right? When a messenger comes to you and, you know, pretty much refreshing you, refurnishing you, and telling you the good news, you return to your youth. Right? That's why the Lord said this. This is Matthew's. Right? Because this thing is all about coming back into the truth. Right? This is Matthew's chapter 18 and verse 3. And it says, and he said, verily I say unto you, except ye be converted and become as little children, ye shall not enter into the kingdom of heaven. So that's the same thing he's saying in John, the third chapter. Except ye be converted and become as little children, ye shall not enter into the kingdom of heaven. Meaning, understand the simple things of the scriptures about who your enemy is, who you are, what the Lord requires of you. Right? So you have to come as a little babe into this thing, man. Right? So the elderly folk that's proud and that's stuck up, you know, and they not gonna get it and they not gonna make it. Right? They're not gonna make it. The Lord said you have to be humble and come as a child into this thing. That's why the Lord said this. This is 1 Peter chapter 2. This is 1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 2, and it reads, as newborn babes desire the sincere milk of the word, that ye may grow thereby. Right? So you got to desire the sincere milk, meaning the truth. Right? You try to tell a proud Christian that the Lord is a so-called black man. They say, well, you know, it don't matter, baby. Right? Well, the Lord said otherwise, man. The Lord said otherwise. Right? You try to tell them the simple things about the scriptures, you know, they'll kind of just, you know, brush you off. Right? That's why they don't have no understanding. Right? That's why the Lord said this in the book of 1 John. It's the book of 1 John chapter 5 in verse 9. Right? I'm starting at verse 10. It says, he that believeth on the Son of the Most High have the witness in himself. He that believeth not the Most High hath made him a liar, because he believeth not the record that God gave his Son. Right? So if you don't believe on the record that the Lord gave his Son, you made the Most High a liar. You don't believe the record. Right? And everything is recorded. It's recorded what the Lord looks like for a reason, man. All of that was recorded to refurnish your mind, because the Lord knew that a people would come, right, and put indoctrinations and philosophies on the scriptures. So the Lord requires you to be born again, right, through the knowledge of the truth, man, right? So let's get a book of St. John chapter 4 and verse 10. Right? Let's get a little more understanding on that. Right? It's the book of St. John chapter 4 and verse 10. And it reads, Yehoshaphat answered and said unto her, if thou knowest the gift of the Most High, and who it is that saith to thee, give me to drink, thou wouldest have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water. So what is that water? If you would ask of the Most High, he would give you the living water, man. Right? If you ask of the Most High in spirit and in truth, he'll give you the living water. Because the Lord said it. The Lord said, call unto me, and I will show you great and mighty things. Right? So let's see what the living water is. Right? This is the book of Ephesians. Right? Chapter 5 and verse 26. It says, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of the water by the word. So you're supposed to be washed in water, drenched or immersed in water by the word, by the truth, by the precepts, by the understanding. Right? This is how you baptize and cleanse yourself, man. Right? Through the Spirit. Right? That's why the Lord said this. This is the book of John, chapter 15. It's the book of St. John, chapter 15 and verse 3. And it reads, now you are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. So now you're clean. Now you know your nationality. Now you know what the Lord requires of you. You understand? Now you know you're supposed to forsake the Sunday church, forsake Christmas, forsake paganism, man. Right? And come out of the world. Now you're clean through the washing of the word. Right? It says, now you are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you, man. Right? So this is how you cleanse yourself. Right? Literally, this is how you cleanse yourself. Right? So let's go back to John chapter 4. Right? And we're going to go to verse 13. Right? Let's see what the Lord said. It says, Yahweh shall answer and said unto her, whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again. Whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again. But whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life. So if you drink of the cup that the Lord gives you, you shall never thirst again, because you're gonna be hydrated with the truth, man. Right? You're gonna have the spirit of truth on you. Right? You're gonna be flowing through the spirit. Right? You're able to cut up doctrines and philosophies and vain deceit. Right? And you're able to be stand stern and strong on your two feet in this truth. Right? And now it's your job to pray and fast and endure to the end. Right? So that's why the Lord said that. Right? So real quick, let me get the, because you can't be, you know, you can't be born again by nothing else but by the Spirit, man. Right? It's not gonna happen. It's not gonna work. You can't be all defiled with philosophies and vain deceit. Right? It's not going to work. Can't be defiled. The Lord said, defile not your temple, man. Right? Roughly paraphrasing. Let me get the book of Job, chapter 14. Right? The book of Job, chapter 14. And I'm going to start at verse 1. It says, man that is born of a woman is a few days and full of trouble. So if you're born of a woman, you finished, man. You're supposed to be born of the Spirit, of the Holy Spirit, and the Spirit of truth, and of the Most High. That's why the Lord said this in the book of Revelation, chapter 14 and verse 4. Right? Bear with me. This is Revelation 14, verse 4, right? And a few verses before, it's talking about Yahweh Shah, right? Coming down, you understand, and, you know, with his elect, right? Verse 4, it says, these are they which were not defiled with woman, for they are virgins. These are they which follow the Lamb whithersoever he goeth. These were redeemed from all men, being the first fruits unto the Most High and to the Lamb. Right? So you can't be defiled with woman. You can't be defiled with philosophy and vain deceit. Right? You gotta, you know, you kind of gotta run away from these things, man. Right? So if you're in the Christian church watching this video, you need to run from the Christian church, man. Because the Lord said, come out of her, my people, that you be not, you know, let's not talk about it. Let's just read it. Right? It's the book of Revelation, right? Shalakia, bear with me, right? Bear with me. Bear with me. Let me find it. Where the Lord said, come out of her, my people, that you be not partakers of her plagues. Right? Bear with me. This is the book of Revelation. Shalakia. Khan, it's the book of Revelation, chapter 18 and verse 4. And it reads, and I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people, that you be not partakers of her sins, and that you receive not of her plagues. Right? The her is talking about Babylon the Great, man. The kingdom of the Edomites, the so-called white man. Come out of all of the philosophies and religions and so on and so forth. You understand? So that you can get the kingdom of heaven, man. That's why the Lord said that. Right? That's why the Lord said that. Right? One more precept on that. It's the book of James. Right? It's the book of James. Right? The brother of the Lord. Right? This is what he's had to say about it. It's the book of James, chapter 1 and verse 26. If any man among you seem to be religious and brighteth not his tongue, but deceiveth his own heart, that man's religion is vain. Right? So if a man is coming among you and he seems to have knowledge, right, so on and so forth, right, but he brighteth not his tongue, right, but deceiveth his own mind, you understand, meaning he's doing contrary to what the Lord told us to do, right? What? That man's religion is vain. Their doctrines are vain. So Christianity is vain because they're doing absolutely contrary to what the Lord said do. Right? Verse 27. Pure religion and undefiled before the Most High and the Father is this, to visit the fatherless and the widows in their affliction, and to keep himself unspotted from the world. Right? Meaning what? You're going to visit the sick, meaning you loving your brother, you keeping the commandments, and you're keeping yourself unspotted from the world, right? From all of the doctrines and all of religions, you understand, that are in this society, right? Because the Lord told us if we love him, keep his commandments and live. That's what the Lord said. Right? So let me get the book of Psalms, chapter 119 and verse 9. All right, let me get a few more precepts. Right? This is Psalms 119 and verse 9. And it reads, wherewithal shall a young man cleanse his way? By taking heed thereto according to thy word. So how can you cleanse your way? Right? How can you really be immersed? By taking heed to what the Lord has commanded us through the scriptures, man. Right? That's how you cleanse yourself. Right? Let me get the book of Revelation, chapter 3 and verse 20. Right? Another precept on that. Because like we said earlier, you can't just go and, you know, just dump yourself in the water and go in the shower and try to wash yourself off and say, well, Lord, you know, I took a shower, you know, I put my Dove deodorant on, right? You know, I wash it, I cleanse my beard, I put my conditioner in there, I'm clean now, Lord, right? Come send a chariot for me, right? That's not what it's talking about, right? So this Revelation 3 and 20, it says, Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him and will sup with him and he with me. Right? So you got to come and knock on the door of the Most High. Right? You got to pray and fast. Right? You got to go through the scriptures, through the precepts. You got to forsake the world. Right? Then the Most High sent his spirit down from the heavens, from the third heavens, via his angels, right? Come and sup with you, right, while you're reading, and you'll get all manner of knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. Right? So I'm gonna get the book of 1 Peter, chapter 1. And verse 23. Right? It's the book of 1 Peter chapter 1 and verse 23. And it reads, being born again, not of corruptible seed, but of the incorruptible, by the word of the Most High, which liveth and abideth forever. So you're only born again, all right, by the word of the Most High, straight up and down, right? Straight up and down what Peter said. Right, so I'm gonna go to the book of Acts. Right, let's go to the book of Acts, chapter 13, and verse 23. Right, watch this. Right, it says, of this man's seed had the Most High, according to his promise, raised up unto Israel a savior, Yahweh Shai. So Israel is a savior for the nation of Israel. I mean, it's like Yahweh Shai is a savior for the nation of Israel. Right, verse 24. When John had first preached before his coming the baptism of repentance to all the people in Israel, and as John fulfilled his course, he said, Whom think ye that I am? I am not he, but behold, there cometh one after me, whose shoes on his feet I am not worthy to loose. Right? So, the point of the matter is, you being immersed in this water is vanity. Right? You're clean now through the washing of the word. Right? That's your true baptism. Knowing your nationality. Knowing who your enemies are. Right? So, the so-called black church has never been baptized. Right, throughout all of the time that we've been on this side of the land, throughout our captivity by the Babylonians, right? So the so-called black church needs to be baptized and be born again with the spirit of truth, right? Brother, endure. Shalom.